Based on the novel, Ragtime is a musical that shows the idea of putting Buffalo Niggle for a playmate.
The first nickel I ever earned, I keep in a little silver frame. It's how I get my company a name, reminding me how very far I came. I was then made of the silhouettes. You made a small improvement, and then you look at the silhouettes that simulate a movement. Well, people seem to like it when the money's going clean, and I follow me.
Gracias. and Bob Fosse. The story is set in 1926, where Foxy Hart and other women murder their lovers and get publicity out of it. It was originally choreographed by Bob Fosse. It later reopened for a revival in 1996 and has still been going for 26 years. It is the longest running revival on Broadway. It has won many Tonys like Best Musical, Best Hook of a Musical, Best Original Score, and Best Performance by a Leading Actor in a Musical. Now presenting Self-Love Tango, choreographed by Kenzie Bonner and performed by Ari Groff, Maddie Airy, Brianne Duffin, Craig Summers, Abby Wilson, and Camilla Gonzalez.
And then he goes over to the library, and then to go down the window. strangled. Well, I was in such a state of shock. I completely blacked out. I can't remember a thing. It wasn't until later, when I was washing the blood off my hands, I even knew they were dead. They had it coming.
Yeah. They wrote Edges while in their sophomore year at the University of Michigan. It is considered to be a song cycle, which is just a group of related songs. Edges has 15
stated, the musical received two Tony Award nominations in 2019 for Best Original Score and Best Orchestrations. The story is inspired by Sting's childhood experiences and the shipbuilding industry of All Saints England, and the closure of the town's shipyard. Sting said, performed by Reese Clerico, Mia Clark, and Iron Man.
Magical circles around my head. I hate to ride on a dream. Carrie tells the story of an outcast teenage girl with telekinetic powers as she navigates high school life. Is being sung by Tommy and Sue as they imagine their perfect prom with each other in this precious romantic moment.
And I'm here in my rental tux, looking like a total dork. The whole thing's kind of cheesy, but nice. And you drag me onto the dance floor, but of course I hate dancing. But it's the last dance of senior year, and I'm the most incredible person I know.
Yeah, right, all I do lately is just mess things up.
I mean it. You don't give yourself enough credit. I bet that you'd be amazed at the sight. You'd see a heart that's furious and true. From my point of view, oh, you shine.
What about you? Why is everything so easy?
If you only knew, half the time I'm just faking it, hoping you won't discover I'm a complete fraud.
Thank you.
York in 2015. The show tells the true story of author J.M. Barrie and how he came up with the tale of Peter Pan. Our performance of the song, When Your Feet Don't Touch the Ground, is choreographed by Kori Wakamatsu and features singers Kelly DeHaan and Hayden Mortensen.
Life becomes so complicated. Years are too much thought of time I wasted, and in each line upon my face is proof I fought and lived another day. When did life become this place of madness, drifting on an empty sea of waves? I may believe I'm in control, and dreaming wasn't all my fault. When your feet don't touch the ground, and your world's turned upside down, here it stays, in this place, above. When your feet don't touch the earth.
that were being expressed across America. Because of this new style of jazz, these musicals became huge successes. This dance, performed by the entirety of MBT and choreographed by Jamie Lamson, showcases Fosse's style of dance to the song Candy by Robbie Williams.
As a revelatory review full of wonderment and revealing tributes to one of the musical theater's greatest composers and lyricists, Sondheim on Sondheim is a portrait of the talented songwriter in his own words and music. Through the use of exclusive interview footage, audiences get an inside look at the life and artistic process of Stephen Sondheim. The songs in
don't go that route.
That's what I said.
trouble was.
Well, Mo, what was their sin?
They were having a wild, wild party.
Truly, truly loves cats, and I love
toes, and I smile so my throat starts to close, but I vow this will never suppose. Well, Dr. O'Hara, I fear that I've buried the headline. The point of the story is murky, I have to concede. I hope that I've shown you tonight. I love your daughter with all of my might. So humbly I stand, asking you for her marital hand. Wedded life will be blissful and grand. Mouser, Miss Mucus, Alexander, the Dander, the P.M.T.
The next number is called Big D, performed by the entire MDT class from the show The Most Happy Fellow. This show opened on Broadway in the Imperial Theater on May 3rd, 1956. The musical, book, and lyrics were written by Frank Pulitzer. It is a song.
Thank you.
music and lyrics by Frank Lesser and book by Abe Burrows and Joe Spurman. The song Sue Me features Adelaide, the lead singer at the Hot Locks nightclub, played by Mia Bagley, and her fiancé, Nathan Detroit, who is a gambler and craps game organizer, played by Jacob Schreiner. Throughout the show, Adelaide is trying to convince Nathan to get married. This song shows the roller coaster of emotions after Adelaide once again tries to convince Nathan to elope. We now present Sue Me from Guys and Dolls.
Well, I gotta go to a prayer meeting.
Nathan, this is the biggest lie you've ever told me!
But I promise it's true!
You promised me this, you promised me that, you promised me anything under the sun, when you gave me a kiss, when you grabbed your hat, and you're off to the races again, when you did the time gone by.
Grab a lawyer and sue me, what can you do me? I love you. Give a holler and hate me, go ahead, hate me, I love you.
Right already, it's true, so new,
wives' remorse, one died of childbirth, and the last one survived. The song of Heart of Stone is about their wife, Jane Seymour, who is talking to Henry about how she is unshakable and can't be broken by him. Please thoroughly enjoy Heart of Stone, performed by Billy Eaton and the MDGC Girls.
Thank you. Jim Kelly, is trying to make any living person say his name three times in order for him to become visible. Adam and Barbara, portrayed by Morgan Walker and Grace Bird, are a newly deceased couple that Beetlejuice unsuccessfully tries to manipulate into becoming his demons for his evil plan. And this attempt is proven unsuccessful when Beetlejuice realizes just how inept the duo is at being scary.
You ask me, but I would. For the sun.
seven brides for seven brothers, the seven brothers decide to kidnap seven young women and try to marry them. Obviously, the girls do not appreciate that very much. Millie, the oldest brother's wife, sends the boys to sleep in a barn throughout the winter. The brothers are kind of miffed, but express their determination that we've got to make it through the winter. Please.
No telling when I'm gonna get to talk to Martha again.
And Liza! Liza!
Finding her way through Paris and making friends along the way. The musical opened on Broadway in March 2017.